Assalamu Alaikum. Welcome to Programming Concepts. I am Naveed Abbas. And in this video, I am going to show you how to create this asterisks image, using OpenCV and Python. I'll use this image to be converted into asterisks image. Let's get started. Open your Python IDE. Create a new file. Import CV2. Read image and store it in image variable. Write the name of image along with its extension. Convert image from BGR to grayscale and store it in gray variable. Blur the grayscale image to reduce noise in the image. It is helpful if you are using a real photo, not like this one. Extract edges from blurred image and store them in edges variable. .30 and 100 are the minimum and maximum threshold values. You may need to change the values for your image. Write the edges in new file as ssjpg. Save the file in the same directory where you have put the image to be converted to edges. Now run the code, and see what happens. We got this image, which is now easier to be converted to asterisks. Now create another file. Import CV2 and NumPy. Read the edges image. We shall reduce the image to width of 100 pixels. It means there will be 100 asterisks per line. 100 to 150 is the suitable range for creating asterisks image. We resize the image using OpenCV resize function. Its dimensions are 100 pixels width and height is 60% of width. Reducing height is very important. When image is drawn with asterisks, its height is increased due to line spacing. We store image as an array in image underscore data variable. Now we loop over all the values in the image underscore data. Now we run the loop, row by row. RGB will store the red, green, and blue color values of the current pixel. If each RGB is greater than 10, it means that pixel is not null. Sorry. There's a problem with indentation of the code. Remember that indentation matters in Python. Be careful. So, now when current pixel is not null, print an asterisk. Here end means the end character of the print function. I specified null as end character, because if you don't specify it as null, print function automatically inserts the next line character at the end. And if the pixel is null, print white space. We store the number of pixels which have been processed in n variable. If n reaches 100, means when we have finished current row, we need to move to the next line. Here I didn't specify end character, because I wanted to print the next line character. Now save the file in the folder where you have put the edges image. We got an error. Let's see. Missing parenthesis. Here we go. I didn't tell you about this person, he is my cousin, Syed Sabi Al-Hassan. He is a freelancer, logo designer, and logo animator. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you in the next video. Take care. Allah Hafiz.